I'm talking about just the 85 South show where you just see it on their channel on their YouTube channel.
It's the same. That's not real blogging, bro. That ain't the same, dog. How? That ain't no real blogging, bro. They not blogging, bro.
I think that should be on there.
I do too.
I don't think so, bro.
What's her boy name? The one that got into it with my boy Charlamagne, where they was into it back and forth.
Who?
The nigga from Rap Radar.
Rap Radar.
Elliot Wilson. They was arguing over the fifth and fourth spot.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. You gotta realize when people interviewing people like these people do, we all interviewing people. Mm-hmm. So it's the same thing when you really think about it.
I say Cheese should be on that list for sure, though. You know what I mean? I think a lot of people said that.
I think people hold the Charleston White against me.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
Boy, ECO, and I'm here with my boy Crisco is in the building. Stop playing, man. Back on here again, man. You keep popping up, man.
I rock with Boss Talk, man. Man, I rock with Boss Talk, man. I think you need to pull me a contract, bro.
Say, I already got the money, nigga.
I want the bread.
We
don't
start like this, man. But we got a special guest here today, y'all, man. Salute. He don't need no introduction, man. He been on here. He probably been on here more than you. He been on here more time
probably
than you, man.
I think he got you about one time.
I've been on here about four or five times.
Y'all about
bro.
Four times, yeah. Didn't it? Both of y'all, man.
Yeah,
check it, man. My boy Sean Cotton's in the building, man. How you doing,
back.
Man?
I'm back, man.
A lot of stuff has happened, man. Shout out to Sko. He in the building, man.
In the building, man. Yeah.
Man, you know, Sko gang, you be causing a lot of problems, man. I wake up at night, remember this.
I don't break the news. We just break the news down, my nigga.
Exactly.
I don't break no news. I just break down what's out there, fam.
Shout out to all the black, I want to say content creators, too. It's hard out here. And, you know, everybody's in it now. Okay. And it's a lot of money. I just want to salute everybody getting it on the YouTube aspect.
Yeah,
I remember
yeah.
about 10 years ago, it was super hard to do it.
Yeah,
now everybody's picking up a mic and it's amazing.
Now you was one of the ones that ushered it in. You know what I'm saying? You ushered it in. Like I said, a lot of respect for you when you first came on here.
You in that Zach TV era, my brother.
Man, Gutter TV.
Yeah, you in
like
that.
Like I said, all of y'all man, y'all really was the ones that really turned this thing up for all of us. So I want to say thank you
for sure. And like I said, like everybody who's like new, even to like the Big D, like rest in peace to him,
man. Rest in
like
peace yourself,
like I always try to at least give everybody an interview or bring people on their platform, like because it's people like to compete, but it's like it's money for everybody.
Yeah,
you say that, but then look at the position you in. You one of the coldest dude to do this, man. In the South, bro.
You're the gatekeeper of this shit, no lie.
Yeah, you one of them ones, so it's easy for you to say that, but if you put the right niggas in the right room, you can get that machismoism going real fast. where egos start to be people worse than ego.
Like real shit, you're right about that. There's a lot of competition out here, but like Vlad TV called me the other day. We chop it up often. And we swapped out. He gave me the AZ Faison interview.
Wow.
Oh, y'all swapped out.
Yeah,
okay.
I gave him somebody else's number to do an interview with that he recently did. And that's just what it's about. Like, it's no, just because this person interviewed him doesn't mean I can't do and ask him a different narrative, go a different way. So, yeah, I don't, the competing is cool because it keeps it keeps you hungry. But at the end of the day, it's like, we all can get money off this.
Let me ask you something real quick. When you did the Faison interview, not the Faison, the AZ interview.
The AZ.
And when you did the AZ interview, how did you come up with, did you know the history of that already? Like far as the Alpo and all that?
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the movie.
Okay, there we go. Paid in Full. Yeah.
And then just watching Vlad interviews and this trying not to really do the same interview he did.
So
I'm trying to get Rare stories about Alpo and Alpo on the plug money.
Yeah, I heard you going there. I heard you bringing up stuff I didn't see in the Alpo documentary.
Exactly.
So
So it was a lot of different things that, and then it's still a touchy subject because he's still in, like people are still alive from that era. So
man,
it was cool.
I gotta ask you about, you know, I be up here mad. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I get upset. I'm old school, so I was looking at like Complex, that Hip Hop HD, you know, when they did that list.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that
and
list.
They didn't put nobody from the South on it. I was mad. Yep. I've been talking about it on my show forever. Mm-hmm. I said, you had Say Cheese down here. You got 85 South down here. You even got
85
Big
Fat. South wasn't on there?
None of them. Wasn't even mentioned.
Now, hold on. What kind of list was this?
It was a podcaster and blogger list. Yeah. You had, I think, you know, of course, Academic, which
but do
he
people
deserved
really consider
it, you know?
Say Cheese a podcast? You feel me? saying?
It was media.
So Vlad TV was on.
Yes.
Everybody was on that thing, man.
That was up on the West, and Bootleg Kev was on there. Mm-hmm. It was everybody.
I most definitely say Say Cheese TV should have been on there. You know what I mean? Cheese, I would say that for sure.
No, 85 South should have been on there. I'm telling you, it's like you can't, South is big, bro. You can't deny these folks. But
I don't look at 85 South that should have been on that list for some. I feel like that's really? Like a show. Yeah, I feel like that's more of like a. I mean, they do. Got
Joe
a little
Budden was on there.
That's media.
You see what I'm saying?
I feel like 85 South is more like a show. You know what I mean? You got comedians. You got three, four guys, and they kind of. You know what I mean? It's not really like the personal interviews. You know what I mean? Kind of like the way Vlad Say Cheese, certain. You know what I mean?
Joe Budden do the same thing they do. It's just hanging with some dudes talking. Yeah. That's what he do.
But you know what I'm saying? They're like in a podcast room. A lot of times, 85 South is like a live show sometimes. Like they doing concerts. Sometimes they be sitting like in a room full of people.
No. I'm talking about just the 85 South show where you see it on their YouTube channel.
That's not real blogging, bro. That ain't the same, dog.
That ain't real blogging, bro.
They not blogging, bro.
I think that should be on there.
I don't think so, bro.
I don't think so. What's the boy's name?
The one that got into it with my boy Charlamagne, where they was into it back in. For
who?
The nigga from Rap Radar.
Elliot Wilson.
They was arguing over the fifth and fourth spot.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. You gotta realize when people interviewing people like these people do, we all interviewing people. Mm-hmm. So it's the same thing when you really think about it.
I say Cheese should be on that list for sure though. You know what I mean? I think a lot of people said that.
I personally think people hold the Charleston White against me.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
You think so?
A lot of people hold their nuts on me because of Charleston.
But these are good interviews. These are good interviews.
But a lot of people don't like Charleston White.
Yeah, you're right.
They just don't understand them. So they hold Say Cheese against. They hold that against me.
Yeah. Now you from Philly, right?
Originally, but I grew up in Arlington.
He grew up here.
I know he grew up here, but I would say
everything that built him up to be who he is today was Dallas.
For sure. I say that a lot. I feel like if I lived in Houston, I don't think Say Cheese would have blew up. There's too much going on.
You feel like right here in Dallas, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Nah, okay. 100%.
Like I said, man, when I seen that list, I get upset because I just feel like it's biased. When you don't mention nothing under Mason Dixon line, bro.
Gillian Waller was on there, right?
Gillian Waller, of course, they're from Philly. Anybody up north was on there.
Have you ever worked with Gillian Waller? Have you ever did anything with him?
Like when Gilly was rapping, but then, like I said, Charleston got into it with Gilly, so it's like I don't know what it's going to be like if I ever see him again. And not blaming Charleston for anything because everybody has a right to their opinion, but Charleston's Charleston.
Yeah.
So he rubs a lot of people the wrong way, and a lot of people tend to take that out on me, but I'll never give up on Charleston. Charleston, he gave me an older audience.
Yeah.
A lot of older people know me now because of Charleston, so I'll never switch sides on Charleston. I always have his back, but Charleston is Charleston.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.